Bach o gatski ex hoc sister listener, chapter 20. Fears and Doubts, written by Crimson _ A on Wattpad. It had been 2 weeks since the incident with the other UA students and the conversation with Katsuki. Now it was no time to spare for the UA Sports Festival. Her wings had fully healed again, and had enough time still to train for it with the rest of the class. It was now morning of the actual sports festival, and you were running downstairs to find your brother screaming your name. YN! K! Shut up and help me put on my tie on, please! You waved the clothes in item in your hand frantically in front of his face. He smiled and nodded. Your hand was shaking slightly as you handed it to him, and he noticed. Nerves? He asked in a suspicious, genuine tone. You sighed and hesitated before nodding slightly, and keeping your eye on the floor, which suddenly seemed very interesting. Kay came in response, signaling you to tell him what was on your mind. He gave in. I'm not good enough. What would the pros even look at my direction? My classmates are strong, and even the other courses have better chance. He doubted. Kay grabbed your shoulders. Not enough to hurt you, though. YN. You are more than that. You are strong and have just as much of a chance as them. Fears and doubts will get you anywhere, so let them go right now. He says. You smile weakly and nodded at your big brother. After one last hug, that became two or three more. Kay reluctantly let go of you, so you could make your way to school. You walked along but kinda needed it. It was peace and quiet. Time skip. We were waiting in the waiting room at the UA. Upon getting there, you were swarmed with reports and TV crews at the front gate. I walked past and brushed crowds of people who were interested in buying random stuff at the stalls. You noticed a few heroes there too, like Mount Lady, Kami Woods as well. You sat near Shoto and talked with him before Mina called you over. You continued to talk with her until Ida burst through the door, which made him slapped open. Aaron, we will be entering the arena shortly. Please remain here until further notice. You stood up and mentally prepared yourself to leave. But that was when you heard Shoto call for Izuku. I think by an objective standpoint, we can all agree I'm better than you. Stares at Izuku, nodded and hung his head. You confused as hell, and honestly had no idea where that idea come from. But you have Almut in the corner helping you out. I'm not going to pry you up about what's going on between you two, but I will beat you. Shota had the most tone cold facial expression you have ever seen. You walk up to the boys and stood between them, seeing Izuku's eyes that were filled with not only tears but fear. That made you a bit angry at Shoto, to be honest. Shoto, that's enough. You said strongly and grabbed his hand while heading straight towards the door. You could see Katsuki in your peripherals, slamming his hands down and getting up to follow you, with smoke elevating from his ears, but Kishima stopped him in his spot. After finding an empty hallway, you stood in front of Shoto with crossed arms and unhappy face, and he avoided your eye contact with you at all costs. Shoto, that's seriously scary, Izuku. What were you thinking? You said dramatically as you stared at Shoto, his eyes downcasted and his head hung low. You thought your sides lift tremble a bit. I apologize, Ryan. He said as you tightly ran your fingers through your hair. He looked so sad, it made you wonder what the reason for this episode was. What was the reason for you talking to Izuku like that? He asked in a more gentle way. Shoto sighed once again and kept his eyes on the floor. I was worried. He finally says, his voice so low and vulnerable. You were perplexed at this. How could he mean? What could he mean? You have looked like a lost puppy or something, because Shoto glanced at you and you then Yeah, and then to the side, before continuing, my father is attending the sports festival. He clears his throat, while youth's face fell into a worried frown. Shota's father has always been unnecessarily harsh on him. He would train Shota for hours on end, until his whole body and face was scared and burned from his left side quirk. He was only 5 at the time. You couldn't think of anything to say to him, so you just open your arms to him, offering a hug to your childhood friend. Shota looked at you, reluctantly but complied, and almost like legit collapsing into your embrace. He let out a right breath as you stroke his red and white locks with your face with his face in your neck. He was never an affectionate person and never liked anyone hugging him. But of course you were expecting. He gave off the most loving and warm touch. Shoto, you are strong, okay? Your father will accept that one day. But until then, you have me and I'll fully accept you. Flaws and all, fears and doubts won't get you anywhere. As you spoke, you fully understood now. To that everything you just had said to Shoto apply to you as well. After calming Shoto down and assuring you that he was fine, you both headed towards the entrance hallway of the stadium. Ida reprimanded you both, but you didn't mind. You stood among your classmates and waited for your class to be led through the stadium while listening to the voice of President Mike over the speakers. You couldn't help but smile at Shoto, who stood next to you, as he puts on a serious face again. You never thought all it took for you to realize your potential was Shoto needing the same reassurance. Thank you, my fiery popsicle. That was chapter 20. I'll be reading chapter 21 tomorrow, I think. No further ado, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!